Oleg and Ludmilla first competed 25 years ago in 1958. It took them 7 years to win their first competition, the Olympic gold medal at Innsbruck in 1964. As John said, they too had put ballet on ice, and in so doing became the best-known skaters in the world. They won 4 world and European crowns and another Olympic gold in 1968. If Oleg had a fault, it was perhaps believing they could go on forever. That 1968 Olympic gold was in their 11th year of competition. In 1969, they were beaten by this lady, Irina Rodnina, and her first partner, Alexei Ulanov. She won Olympic, world, and European titles before switching to Alexander Zaitsev in 1973. They won the European...
Well, the music has broken down, but they're keeping on with their program, and this is another unprecedented occasion. I can't remember during my time in skating that skaters have carried on when their music has stopped, but they are going on. Well, they're going through with this, and they're really skating extraordinarily well. Everything they're doing is coming off. The crowd are absolutely roaring them on, and they've gone now, and there's only 5 seconds over. What a roar, what a cheer!
And what a performance. They won and they just kept on winning world and European titles. In 1975, they were married and celebrated with another Olympic gold in 1976. Then the competition stopped in 79. Irina had a baby, Sasha.
Maybe this is last year, or maybe we skate when our little Sasha...
And back they came in 1980 and won a gold medal for Sasha with this performance in the Europeans. Irina had now won the European 11 times and the world 10 times. There was just the 1980 Olympic Games left, and Irina's third Olympic victory gave us one of the unforgettable pictures from Lake Placid.